again, and welcome to Winning with the Wrangler at Dick Powell's Leadership Corner, brought to you by Earth, Wind, Fire, Water Training and Development, where our passion is building leaders of today and tomorrow. Leaders, we're going to look at some things today that I believe that you're going to want to take note of. And the first subject that we're going to bring up today as a leadership piece, doers do and slackers don't. Now, I don't say that even with lightly sense of words. And I've had people really kind of tear me up by using those words about slackers. But let me ask you a question. Are you a doer or are you a slacker? You see, do you do what needs to be done, or do you put it off until the last moment and then rush to make it happen? You see, doers are disciplined risk takers who are motivated to use their passion, their gifts, their talents to achieve plans in life. And slackers, well, not so much. You see, this whole thing of doers and slackers are really about people who take action, leaders, or not. And that's really what we're looking at today. Now, some say this isn't really a big subject, but I really disagree. You see, doers, I'm going to tell you, doers are researchers. They do their homework so that they are ready to attack the opportunities as they are presented. They are always collecting information, never knowing when they will need each piece that they're collecting. They are readers of everything and anything, and they are observers of life and that all that it has in it. These people who are doers, they take the time to get to know people. They build relationships. They read everything, books, magazines, articles, whether it's on the internet, whether it's on a hardbound, it just doesn't seem to matter. But they're always putting more information into themselves so that when an opportunity kind of floats by, they know what it is and they can reach out and grab a hold of it. Well, yes, sometimes that is taking a risk, but because they have done the research and they've gotten ready, it's a limited, you know, risk. And that's the piece that makes most fun, just so you know. The most fun that happens in any kind of person's life is grabbing hold of a new adventure. At least I hope that's what gets you excited. As leaders, that should be one thing that really makes you get going and get up in the morning. You see, doers are people who are preparers. They get prepared. They prepare for the little things that might pop up. You understand? Might pop up in life as well as the big things that surely will. I was talking to a young fellow the other day. He says, man, I'm just having a terrible week. The hot water tank went off. The dishwasher died. And I just don't. Well, you know, were you prepared? Did you put away some money? Did you take care of the maintenance? You know, there was a lot of questions I wanted to ask him. But having lived through that myself, I just smiled and said, yeah, life is a booger. And sometimes it grabs a hold of the best of us. But here's the thing. If you get prepared for the little things in life, as well as the big things, you need to employ a long-range plan, a mid-range plan, a short-range plan, and a daily plan that keeps you on track towards those short, mid, and long-range goals or milestones. Sounds pretty easy, but it's not. You see, these people, these preparers, as we're calling them, they have found out the five secrets of planning. First, they think through the who, what, when, where, and how. And by thinking that through, it's going to take some time. You can't do that overnight, and you can't do it in one session. It always drives me crazy when a company calls me and says, we want to do a planning session for the year, and we want to do it in like 2 hours. Can you help us walk through that? I said, well, I can help you walk through it, but you're not going to get very far in 2 hours. There's just so much to it. Now, once it's done, then, yeah, you can every month or every quarter, you can go look at it for a couple hours and see where you're at and see if you need to adjust things. Now, number two, the second thing is write it down. Third is put dates on of each item as to when it will be completed on a calendar. Then you can backdate so you can do certain things, so that by the time that date comes up, it is completed. And using backdated opportunities really is a smart thing to do. That's one of the biggest reasons for doing planning to begin with, is to see the end in mind, but to plan for it. A fourth thing is you need to share it with someone or the whole team. Hopefully the whole team has been a part of this process, and the whole team actually holds on to the whole thing so they can watch and see how things are moving. Where do they need to help? What do they need to do? How do they need to do it? And the fifth thing is you need to write down on that same calendar, not on the due date, but who's accountable to see that it happens. Might even need to put down on that calendar with the who's accountable, the budget that goes with it. You see, because these things all start to work together and they become so as one when we don't share all the information with everyone, it becomes a secret. And in any organization, company, family, when secrets are made, people make up their own answers. And when they make up their own answers, they could be right, but most of the time they're not. And then they're hard to live down. So doers get prepared, and they share all their information. They share it because they know if it's written down and shared, they're more likely to achieve. It's a pretty good thing. Now, doers are executors. Now, I don't mean they're out killing people, but I mean they're executing the plan. Now, you see, they know that doing the research and being prepared is just not enough. That's just kind of like the icing on top of the cake. They must put the plan into action. What are they doing daily? What are you doing daily? What's the team doing daily so that they live the mission and achieve the vision? You see, this stuff all starts to come together in such a way that it really has to go together. And the plan is usually put together by the doers, not the slackers. Slackers always come to me and they want to do a 1-year, 3-year, and a 5-year plan. They want to do it in a couple hours, and I look at them and just smile. I have to tell you, they're the ones who don't share it with everybody, because someone at the top or somewhere in the middle did the whole thing and then lay it on people, and no one buys in, and they wonder why. But executors, you see, it's different. They put the plan into action. And by using the plan and the dates as guidelines, as guides, it makes the completion all the more meaningful. Because the whole team is part of this. It's not just one person. It's not just one thing. Everyone's pulling together for the same opportunity. And if they're all doers, boy, that's fun. If you got some slackers, might hold some people back. Might want to look at that. I'm telling you, it's a piece that you need to spend time with. Now, doers also are disciplined. You know, they're risk takers who are motivated to use their passion, their gifts, their talents to achieve their plans in life. I found also that these doers who are disciplined in business and in companies and organizations are the ones who get things done. They put things on calendars, they plan out opportunities, and then they backdate and find out what do I have to do in order to get it completed by that certain time. They're the ones who stay on budget. They're the ones who come in under budget. They're the ones who are disciplined to get up and do the same thing, do what needs done every single day to take a move ahead, both in their personal lives and their corporate lives. Doers do, slackers don't. You see how this all starts to come together from a business organization. And I'm starting to see, and Robin and I are both starting to see, that we're putting this into different categories. we're seeing that there's this thing that we're calling BOFF, B-O-F-F, business, organizations, family, and friends. We're seeing that these leadership techniques, these leadership opportunities, are all the same in each of the locations. We're seeing that the people who are doers and they're disciplined in their family world are doers and disciplined in their business and organizations and with their friends. It's amazing how this works. Now, I know that slackers don't like to do research, you see. You know, taking the time to do the homework is a much too of a bother. Now, you've known who these people are. You grew up with them. They always have an excuse of why an opportunity has passed them by. They do not collect information for the future use, and they surely don't read a book. If I had a dollar for every time I was told I did all my reading in high school or college, and I just don't have time to read now, I'm going to tell you what, Miss Robin and I would be a millionaires. It's amazing to me how many people have collected that little piece of paper, stuck it up on the wall, and that's where it stayed. And then they wonder why they don't get moving ahead. Slackers don't. Doers do, and slackers just don't. They don't do the research. Now, slackers, well, they're never prepared. They don't like to have any plans that might hold them accountable. You see? And they do not have a team to share with, or they have the Lone Ranger attitude. I can do it all by myself. And you know what? If you leave me alone, I'll do it at the last minute. I'll do it better than anybody else. And we all know how that works out, don't we? Doers do. Slackers don't. Slackers just don't execute either. You know? They just no discipline. There's no accountability. They have no guide, so things only get done in a reactive mode, not a proactive mode. You see, planning lets us be proactive, lets us get her done. When reactive is, don't fix it till it breaks. I love that when people tell me, well, we'll fix it when it breaks. Well, when it breaks, do you have the money? Do you have the time? Do you have the inclination to fix it when it breaks? Do you have to hire someone? You see? But if you've done a little bit of planning and ahead, maybe it wouldn't break. Doers do. Slackers don't. So when they don't execute, when they don't have a guide, what I see over and over is the problem we face all the time. It's people with plum disease. Now, I know I spell a little funny because I went to a little school. So I spell plum, P-L-O-M. And I want to tell you about this disease. This disease is so rampant and it's so catching that you can catch it by just sitting next to someone, being in the same auditorium with someone. You know what? You can catch it across the phone. Poor little old me, Plum. Poor little old me. And right behind that disease is just as deadly. Just as deadly as you owe me. You know, the right behind that is I can't, and I won't, and I don't know how. It's okay for you, but not for me. I'm having a bad hair day. Well, if you still got hair, it's good, because I'm losing mine. And the list goes on and on. You see, this disease that we're having that happens when doers do and slackers don't. The slackers, you see, get a hold of this disease, and it grows. And the bad problem with it is that if you're an organization, business, family, friends, it can run rampant unless you stamp it out by doing. And doers do, slackers don't. My grandpa raised me, and he often would say, if you want to complain, moan and groan, go somewhere else so I don't have to hear your noise. If you want to be something, have something, let's go to work. He was so far ahead of his time, I believe, that raising me, this thing of getting up and going to work every day, became a habit. But that isn't all. It made me a doer instead of a slacker. So I'm always thankful to my grandpa for doing that. So some of those days he would wake me up and I'd have to go out and work in the field. Wasn't real happy about it. But I'll tell you what, doers do, slackers don't. Now here's the bottom line. Everyone, every single person, every one of us has a choice to make. And you see, we can make that choice, whether to be a slacker or a doer. And it's up to us to either put it in place or leave it behind. And every one of us has that ability to make that choice. I'm going to take and really take us to another spot here, because I believe it's really going to be a place that you're going to want to hear about. You see, this goes right along with doers do and slackers don't. It's called busy. I bet every one of us has said, I'm just too busy. Well, let's look into that. You see, are we a society of busy? Do you and your family always have to be on the go? Does staying home and enjoying each other sound just terrifying? Now, I'm going to tell you what. These are some big questions in America right now. I think they've been there for quite a while. You see, my personal observations are that the children do not get time to be creative and learn the joys of self-entertainment. You know, when we didn't have anything but going outside and finding a stick to play with, you found something to do with it. But you see, I see young people and adults alike that have to be busy every moment of the day, always going to the store, to the movies, to the beach, to the soccer field, to the baseball field, hockey rink, with no downtime except travel time, and then they're on their cell phones. Now you know exactly what I'm talking about. The numbers in church youth groups, Sunday school, Girl Scouts, Boy Scouts is falling all the time. The notion of leadership and accountability seems to be falling and just going away. Creativity is something that those strange people in artist colonies seem to do. You know, if people of all ages are not busy at work with a communication device in their hands or eating out, they have lost and must quickly find something to stay busy. It truly is an amazement to me. Now, I love my devices, I won't lie to you, but I really love talking to people face to face and building relationships. Doers do, slackers don't. One of the things that kind of amazes me a little bit is cooking and preparing a meal. Seems in our house one of the easiest things to do. Miss Robin and I seem to be able to plan and put on a meal in about 30 minutes or less. Now, I will tell you, she's taught me how to go to the grocery store and shop, and she's taught me a lot about cooking, but it's not a big deal to make a meal. Yet our fast food companies are the greatest growing rate, and they're growing at the rate of our waistlines. Just look around. Busy? Are you busy? You see, we want to watch sports, but we're too busy to go outside and actually get involved, and we're willing to pay huge sums of money so we can sit and watch. It amazes me when I go by the football stadium, we have a football team here in town. We have a baseball team in town. We have a hockey team in town. And you go by those places, and the cheapest ticket is around $50. And so that's two of you. That's $100. And it costs $20 to park. And so that's $120. And then if you want to eat or drink, you know, you're going to spend another $50 or $60. So it's a couple $100 night. Who in their right mind has a couple $100 to go out and waste on that kind of thing? I just don't know. Now, if you like sports, okie dokie. But I surely would like to look at your budget when you tell me that you're poor and you don't have anything. You see, I constantly hear this. I'm so busy. And it's almost with a tear in their eye. I ask, doing what they, you know, what are they doing? And they seem to have to search for an answer. It is like we have raised a society of people who are busy and not productive. Not caring, not intuitive, not sharing, not accountable for their actions. Leaders, here we have a responsibility. we have a responsibility to change this. We have an opportunity to move into a different direction of working with people who are around us. And this goes to our BOF, our business, our organization, our family, our friends. And this gets worked in every single day. How many times have you heard someone say, "I'm exhausted, I'm just so busy," and you ask them what they've been doing, and they really can't give you an answer, but they know that they were doing something. This is getting to be a piece that is hurting our whole country. I think it's hurting our whole world, but slackers, you know, don't. Doers do. Slackers don't. You see how this works together? You see, slackers are busy, not productive. Slackers are the ones who are saying, you know, I'm so busy, I'm going to stop at a drive-in to get a cup of coffee because I'm so busy I can't make it at home where it would cost me 23 cents instead of $5 when I drive through the drive-thru. Doesn't make sense to me. When I look at people's budgets and say, you know, when they tell me they don't have anything, Robin and I look at their budgets and we start looking at things like they've got a person that cleans their house 3 days a week. We've got a person who cooks their food. We've got a person that cleans the pool and cuts the grass and trims the trees. And everything is, I'm so busy. And you start looking at their budget and you start looking what they're doing, spending time. And you, do you enjoy doing these things? Well, no, but, you know, that's what I'm expected to do. I said, well, who expects you to do that? You see, leaders, we have put the wrong information into their minds. The only way you can truly be productive is every once in a while sit down and take an evaluation of who you are, where you are, and what do you want to do. You see, this evaluation includes the vision, your big picture, and being able to get it down on a piece of paper. If you're married, you have a significant other, you know, if you have a business, if you're in an organization, I don't care where it's at. I just came from a board meeting just here recently where the organization did not even have a vision or a mission, and they surely didn't have a strategy, and they wondered why they were failing. When I work with families that are failing, and it always comes down to money and time. I'm busy. I don't have enough. And as we start looking at where they're spending their time, how they're managing it, what they're doing with it, how they're organized. We look at the budget really quick and I can tell you where the money goes and how it happens. Sad tale of woe. Doers do, slackers don't. Have we really gotten so busy that we can't see to the other side of the situation? Leaders, I'm telling you, it is our duty, it is what we're called to do in our organizations, in our businesses, in our families, in our friends, in our church youth groups, our Sunday schools, our Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, whatever other organization that you can imagine. Leaders, we're falling down the job. We need to do better. And we need to install these kind of critical things into not only the young people, but ourselves as leaders. Doers do, slackers don't. You see, this is such a terrible thing because people do what people see and people repeat what people hear. And that's what makes this such an opportune time for all of us leaders to get together and make a difference. When I talked to you about plum disease, I hope that you understood that I was kind of making fun, but I really wasn't. This thing of poor little old me and it, with another disease right behind it that's you owe me, those two things seem to be the call words of today's. In leadership, we're not doing a very good job at erasing the poor little old me and the you owe me. We're not doing a very good job of getting rid of and never having to hear of the thing is I can't. I told my granddaughter the other day, she said, I can't. I said, well, it doesn't live here. Can't doesn't live here, you know. You can, you will, you do. You take a chance, you make a risk. But you can do something. See? Mr. Ford says, you can and you can't, both are true. And he was right. The thing that comes out and says, I won't, well, that's a choice. And that, my friends, leadership, I'm trying to get across to you, this whole piece is a choice. I won't is a choice. Same way with I'll try. I don't know how. Well, if you don't know how, let's learn. You see, doers do, slackers don't. Doers would say, well, teach me. Or where do I go get that information? Or they would go out on their own and learn. Slackers would wait for someone to come along and say, look, you need to learn to sit down and let's go now. And it'd have to be on their world. When I worked for a large organization, the slackers always said, you know, if the company wanted me to know that, they would do teach me on company time. But you see, the doers were going out and learning on their own time and coming back and getting promoted and moving up. And the slackers kept saying, but you're leaving me behind. You see, leaders, I sometimes think that we're not doing our jobs, and that's building more leaders. The one where it's, okay for you, not for me, I'm going to tell you what, that's in itself an excuse. It's okay for you, but that's not for me. Well, great, what's for you? What are you going to do? I hope you see how I am making fun of it a little bit, but I'm really not. I'm really darn serious about doers do and slackers don't. I'm really, really serious about this thing about being busy. It really goes together. When you're so busy that you can't see the other side, are you a slacker or are you a doer? You're going to have to answer that for yourself, but I'm going to tell you what, you're going to probably not like the answer. Because you see, doers do. They move ahead. Doers do by doing what needs done, when it needs done, how it needs done, before anyone asks them to do. Doers learn on their own and want to, and they're excited and have an enthusiasm. Slackers sit back and wait. Which one are you? This is important stuff. Leaders, we have to take it by the tail and we have to do something about it. Now, this is going to happen through encouragement, you bet. It's going to happen through mentoring, you bet. It's going to happen through coaching, yes, it will. I believe everyone has the innate opportunity to learn these things. I truly do. I just don't think sometimes as leaders we grab a hold and do the instruction the way we need to. Leaders, I understand that a lot of times this is a scary piece of our world. Letting someone know that they're a slacker and there's another way that they do have a choice and they can make it do it. Talking to someone in a nice manner that busy does not mean productive. That productive is totally different. And that doers do and slackers don't. When I wrote these things, I was pretty much criticized by some people I sent them out to because I always do that before I put things on the air. I came back and rewrote it and put the busy onto it because I believed that the busy is a counterpart of doers do and slackers don't. I believe it's a symptom. It's a symptom of where we're at in today's world. We have to stay so busy because we're afraid to make relationships. We're afraid to talk to one another. We're afraid to share. And that's because we have to be careful of the words we use. Well, on behalf of myself, Dick Powell, and the whole Leadership Corner team, I do want to say thank you for being a part of today's program. Our hope is that you've received a nugget of wisdom and guidance that will help you build your leadership ability. Now, if you have any questions or comments on today's program, send me an email, dick@leadershipwrangler.com, dick@leadershipwrangler.com. If you would like to set an appointment with Ms. Robin or myself, go to our website, www.leadershipwrangler.com, www.leadershipwrangler.com. Click on the little button, set your time and date, and we'll get to you, I guarantee it. Or if it's just a burning desire that you need an answer and you want to talk to somebody right today, give us a call, 727-422-1833, 727-422-1833. And remember, Leadership Wrangler is always here for you. But until next time, this is DW the Wrangler saying, ride hard.